Natural resources are free gifts of nature given to mankind. Soil is one of the most essential among all natural resources. After air and water, the next essential requirement of man is food. We know that food crops cannot be grown without soil. India has a wide variety of physiological features and diverse climatic conditions. Therefore, we find a wide variety in the soil also. Soil helps in growing a wide variety of crops. India has favorable conditions for growing different crops, and agriculture is the main occupation. In this chapter, Geography Unit 4, India Soils, we learn about the origin, composition, and uses of different types of soil. We also read about the causes of soil erosion and various methods for conservation of soil. In this chapter, we learn about the following: meaning and importance of soil in India, types of soils and their distribution, soil erosion, causes and effects, and soil conservation. Meaning and importance. What is soil? Soil is the thin surface layer of the earth comprising of closely intermixed mineral and organic substances. It is very important natural resource of India because agriculture is the main occupation of the people. Agricultural production is basically dependent on the fertility of soil. Soil formation of India is mainly related to the parent rock, relief, climate, and natural vegetation. So, there is a wide variety of soils in India. Soils of India can be classified into six main types: alluvial soil, black soil, red soil, laterite soil, desert soil, and mountain soil. These are the six types of soil classified in India. Alluvial soil. The soil that are composed of alluvium are called alluvial soil. They are formed from the sediments deposited by the rivers, as in Indo-Gangetic plain, and by the sea waves in coastal plain. Alluvial soil is very extensively found and very important in India. They contribute greatly to the development of agriculture in the country. The main crops that are grown in alluvial soil are wheat, paddy, sugarcane, cotton, and jute. Black soil. Black soil is the second type of soil found in India. Black soil is also known as rigar or black cotton soil. Why it is called black cotton soil? Because they are best suited for cotton cultivation. Black soil is most suitable for cotton cultivation. Therefore, black soil is also called black cotton soil. They are derived from basalt rocks. So, they are dark gray to black in color with high clay content. They are highly retentive of moisture and extremely compact. So this black soil has the capacity to retain moisture and they are compact. Black soil are best suited for cultivation of cotton, sugarcane, jowar, maize, pulses, wheat and chilies. Black soil, areas of black soil and cotton crop. Black soils are largely found in the Deccan basalt trap. You can see in the map, Deccan basalt trap region. So black soil are largely found in the Deccan basalt trap, including Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, parts of Telangana, northern part of Karnataka, parts of Gujarat and Tamil Nadu. Red soil. They are formed from the weathering of granite, gneiss and other crystalline rocks. The color of these soils are generally red or reddish brown. You can see the red soil here and the crystalline rock and gneiss. Red soil is sandier and less clay. Red soil is sandier and less clay. So they do not retain moisture unlike black soil. Red soil is spread extensively in Tamil Nadu. They are found extensively in Tamil Nadu. They are also found in southern Karnataka, Madhya Pradesh, Orissa, Kerala, Goa, Bihar, Uttar Pradesh, Assam, Manipur, Nagaland and West Bengal. Red soils are ideal for cultivation of ragi, millets, groundnuts, tobacco and potato. A variety of crops can be grown in these soil if there are irrigation facilities. So if there are irrigation facilities, a variety of crops can be grown. Laterite soil. These soils are formed in tropical areas under the condition of high temperature and rainfall. They are mainly found in uplands of Western Ghats, Eastern Ghats, Chota Nagpur Plateau, Meghalaya Plateau, Rajmahal Hills, Vindhyas and Satpuras. Laterite soil are leached soils. Therefore, they are not fertile and are of limited use for agriculture. Laterite soils undergo a process called leaching. So they lose their fertility in that process and therefore laterite soil are not fertile and are of limited use for agriculture. However, crops like cashew, rubber, tea, coffee and paddy can be grown in this soil. Laterite soil and the areas where lateral soil are found. Desert soil. These soils are formed under desert and semi-desert conditions. They are largely found in northwestern part of India, a major part of Rajasthan, southern Haryana, Punjab and northern part of Gujarat. They are fairly friable. They have a high content of soluble salt. They are sandy and low in moisture and humus. Therefore, they are not suitable for cultivation of crops. Desert soil are not suitable for cultivation of crops. Give reason. Desert soil are fairly friable. They have a high content of soluble salt. They are sandy and low in moisture and humus. Therefore, desert soil are not suitable for cultivation of crops. Some crops can be grown where irrigation facilities are available. Desert soil and the areas where desert soil are found. Mountain soil. These soils are mainly found on the slopes of mountains and hills covered by forests. They are mostly formed due to the decomposition of organic matter. Hence, they are rich in humus and are fertile. Mountain soils are very useful for plantation crops such as tea, coffee, and fruits. They are largely found in Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Manipur states, and along the Western Ghats. Mountain soil consists plenty of decomposed matter, humus. Soil erosion. Soil erosion refers to the removal of topsoil by natural agents. Natural agents such as the rivers, the glaciers, winds, sea waves, etc. remove the top layer of the fertile soil and decrease the fertility of soil. So, what is soil erosion? Soil erosion refers to the removal of topsoil by natural agents. Which are the natural agents? The rivers, the glaciers, winds, sea waves, etc. remove the top layer of the fertile soil and decrease the fertility of the soil. Soil erosion is one of the important problems of India. So, what are the causes of soil erosion? The causes of soil erosion are deforestation, overgrazing, shifting cultivation, faulty methods of cultivation, and use of topsoil for making bricks, tiles, etc. So, let us see. Deforestation. Deforestation refers to large-scale cutting down of trees in forests. Large-scale cutting of trees is nothing but deforestation. Overgrazing. That is, taking cattle and other livestock for grazing in the same area. So, when the cattle graze extensively in a particular area, it amounts to overgrazing. Shifting cultivation. Shifting cultivation was generally practiced by tribal people who lived in forest and hilly areas. They select a patch of land for agriculture. They cut down the trees, burn them, carry out agriculture for 1 or 2 years. When the soil loses its fertility, they abandon, they give up that patch of land, select another patch of land, and this process continues. So, this was shifting cultivation. Nowadays, shifting cultivation is not practiced. Faulty methods of cultivation. Faulty methods of cultivation refers to wrong selection of crops or the type of soil. We must choose the right type of crop for the right type of soil. And wrong selection of fertilizers. So, even selection of wrong fertilizers also is a method of faulty method of cultivation. wrong method of irrigation. We must follow the correct method of irrigation. And we must use modern methods of cultivation. However, there are places where farmers use old and primitive methods of cultivation and old and primitive implements or tools. So all these are involved in faulty methods of cultivation. Use of topsoil for making bricks tiles. You can see the top layer of the soil is being used for making bricks, tiles and even pots. So this will result in soil erosion. So what are the effects of soil erosion? Loss of fertility and fall in agricultural productivity. So soil erosion effects are: number one, loss of fertility and reduction in agricultural productivity. It leads to silting and floods and change of course of rivers and reduction of capacity of reservoirs. So what happens? The soil which gets eroded gets accumulated in some places. They are called silt. When the silt gets accumulated, when the next time when the water flows, it results in flood. When the silt becomes more and they change the course or change the direction of the rivers, and when these eroded soil flows into reservoirs and gets deposited, and the capacity of the reservoir also decreases. Groundwater level is lowered and decrease in soil moisture. Soil erosion results in the lowering of groundwater and decrease in the moisture of the soil. And vegetation cover dries up and drought increase. When the water level is lowered, so the vegetation that grows or the vegetation cover dry up due to lack of water, and it results in condition of drought or famine. And because of all these factors, the economy as a whole suffers a great setback. So these are the effects of soil erosion. Conservation of soil. So the remedy for soil erosion is conservation of soil. What is meant by conservation of soil? Protection of soil from erosion and conservation of fertility of the soil is called soil conservation. So what is soil conservation? Protection of soil from erosion and conservation of the fertility of the soil is called soil conservation. Here there are two aspects. First, we have to protect the soil from erosion. Second, we have to preserve or conserve the fertility of the soil. Together, it is called soil conservation. So, what are the methods of conservation of soil? How to conserve soil? There are several methods of conserving soil. One is afforestation. Second, reforestation. 3. Controlled overgrazing. 4. Contour farming. 5. Construction of check dams. 6. Contour bunding. And lastly, gully control and bench terracing. So, now let us see and understand what are these methods. Afforestation. Whenever, wherever, occasion provides, we must plant more and more number of saplings. Man-made efforts to grow trees plant by planting saplings is called afforestation. Or reforestation. Wherever for necessary reasons, necessary requirements, trees have been cut. So, in the same place, more number of plants must be planted. It is called reforestation. Wherever trees have been cut down, we must undertake reforestation. So both afforestation and reforestation must be carried on a very large scale. Controlled overgrazing. So we must control the grazing of cattle, livestock, cattle, buffalo, sheep. So we must control, we must mark certain areas, we must allow the cattle to graze only in that area. We should not let it go anywhere. So we must control overgrazing. Contour farming. You can see the picture. Contour farming is generally carried out in hilly areas where the land is slope. So there, the type of cultivation or the type of plowing which is carried out across the slopes is called contour farming. By this, we can control the soil erosion and also loss of water. So this is method generally practiced in hilly areas where the land is slopey. Construction of check dams. Whenever any stream of water, a river or a canal flows, so at regular distances, we must construct check dams. So these check dams collect the eroded soil, the soil which gets eroded, and periodically the soil which get accumulated behind the check dams, which is called silt. So time to time that silt has to be removed so that the capacity of the dams will remain always full. So at proper intervals, at proper distances, check dams have to be constructed. So we can prevent the soil going and reaching the reservoir and thereby decreasing the capacity of the reservoir. This is called check dams. Contour bunding. Contour bunding. We can see bunds are constructed at different intervals. So these bunds prevent the soil from passing on to the next level. So they will prevent soil erosion. So in agricultural lands, we can see these bunds are constructed. They help to prevent soil erosion, soil getting eroded and flowing to other places. So contour bunding. Gully formation. You can see in the picture, due to heavy floods, heavy rainfall, land gets eroded and pits or gully are formed. So every time whenever there is heavy rainfall, there are heavy floods, a part of that land, a part of the soil gets eroded and they are carried to different places. So we have to control the formation of gully. In the another picture, we can see some slabs are constructed, concrete blocks are put there so that the gully formation can be avoided. Bench terracing. This is the method followed in hilly areas. In Karnataka, we can see there is Agumbe, there is Sringeri, where the land is not flat, but they get heavy rainfall. Even in Nilgiri Hills, in Ooty, and such places, where the land is not slope, but the soil is good, there is very good rainfall. So in such places, to carry out agriculture, to stop soil erosion, it is also known as step farming or bench terracing. You can see the picture, you will understand the concept of bench terracing. So where agriculture can be carried out by following the bench terracing method, and we can prevent water flowing down and we can also prevent soil getting eroded. So these are some of the methods of conservation of soil.